Good morning, dear assistants. We are going to present our paper, Wearable Devices Information Security and Overview. First, we are going to present the agenda. Why security? Analyze parameters, RED model-based analysis, STRIDE model-based analysis, security recommendations, conclusions. Why security? Wearable technology provides the user with friendly and personalized services with multiple information sensors. However, they handle personal and sensitive information, which if used by malicious users could cause a lot of problems. Within the security aspects, previous analysis has been conducted on real examples of wearable devices. First, the Google Glasses were the first wearable devices to start the growth of wearable technology. However, there is a concern about the vulnerability to privacy of the person who used them. Second, Fitbit Smart Fitness Bands used on the wrist provides measurements of human activity. But one of the most important issues encountered on these devices has been the lack of authentication in the data monitoring aspect, allowing attackers to get the data easily without the user noticing. Third, Samsung smartwatch devices also contain vulnerabilities because a study conducted by HP claims that 100% of the devices evaluated have different attack doors, such as weak authentications or do not contain encryption, among others. Now we're going to present you the analyzed parameters. First, the RED model. Its name represents damage, reproducibility, exploitability, affectability, and discovery. This model allows you to calculate the risk for each of the threats. Threats have a level of severity assigned as follows: low from 5 to 7, medium from 8 to 11, and high from 12 to 15. Here in the table, you can see each of the threats and its risk level. In high, you can see on the damage aspect, the attacker can ignore the protection mechanism of the security system and obtain authorization from the administrator to execute programs arbitrarily. On medium, the attacker can obtain sensitive information from the user, and low if the attacker can obtain only general identifying information. For the reproducibility, on high, the attack can be carried out several times and executed at any time without restriction. Medium, if the attack can only be repeated at a specific situation or point in time. And low, if despite known security vulnerabilities, it's difficult to repeat the attack. On the exploitability aspect, it's high risk if a novice attacker can perform the attack directly using scripts or simple tools. Medium, if an attacker with some experience can carry out the attack, but relevant technical knowledge is required. And low, if it requires the experience of a computer security professional with a high understanding of the attack. Affectability represents a high risk if all users are affected. Medium, when only some users are affected, and low if it affects only a small percentage of users and can be quickly recovered. Finally, we have the discoverability aspect, which will be high risk if the vulnerability information is defined by severity levels, is publicly exposed, and is easy to implement repeatedly. Medium, if the vulnerability exists in a service that is rarely used and its impact is very low, requiring a specific information to identify it. And low, if the attack on vulnerability is slight, its implementation requires a specific condition and is extremely difficult to detect. The kappa coefficient. This parameter is used to analyze the results obtained from the RED model through surveys of two experts chosen according to their experience in security matters and because they are researchers on the subject of cybersecurity and data analysis from the university sponsoring the research. The kappa coefficient proposed by Jacob Cohen 1960 refers to a statistical measure that allows comparing the agreement observed by two evaluators in a group of data. The equation used to obtain the kappa coefficient is the following, the one that you can see in the presentation, where PRA refers to the agreement observed between the evaluators and PRE is the probability of agreement by chance. In case there is a complete agreement between the two evaluators, the K coefficient will be equal to one. Otherwise, it will approach zero or even negative values in a 2x2 matrix. The following table that you can see also here shows the strength of agreement proposed by Landis and Koch in 1977 based on the kappa coefficient. In this table, we can see that if kappa coefficient is less than zero, the strength of agreement is null. If it is from 0.0 to 0.2, it's poor. From 0.2 to 0.4, weak. From 0.4 to 0.6, moderate. From 0.6 to 0.8, good. And if it's from 0.8 to 1.0, it's very good. This threat model. To identify threats, it's necessary to categorize them. That's why the threat model is used. This one identifies and examines its security aspects. The model categorizes threats according to the intention of the attack and allows the development of certain security policies. Here, you can see in the table the six threats analyzed, the security property affected by it, its description, and how it acts. First, spoofing. This threat uses the credentials of other legitimate users to authenticate themselves to the system and access information. Tampering. It allows to modify the information to be stored in databases, file systems, or network traffic. Repudiation. The system does not have the ability to track user activities. Information disclosure. Allows access to unauthorized files or data in transit. Denial of service. Denies valid users access to temporarily unavailable databases and applications. And elevation of privilege. Obtain access permissions to resources to access or damage information. Now, we are going to present the RED model-based analysis. The following tables show the results of the survey conducted to two experts, allowing to calculate the risk of each of the 18 evaluated attacks through the previously explained threat parameters, where each one will be graded on the scale from 1 to 3, to finally obtain a total on a scale from 5 to 15 that will allow the level of risk to be decided, being this low, medium, or high. The survey results showed that the most dangerous attack for wearable devices is the phishing attack with the highest risk rating, that is 15. Through this attack, you can ignore the system protection mechanism, execute malicious code, modify data, cause loss of control of the application, and compromise the user's privacy. In addition, it can be performed several times at any time, even by a novice using simple and easy to implement scripts or tools that are publicly exposed on the internet, thus affecting all users of the victim device. On the other hand, the least risky attack is the signature wrapping attack. This one received a rating of 5 by both evaluators, which placed it at the low risk level. Through this attack, you can obtain only general identification information. Its technical complexity is high, and it's difficult to repeat. In addition, it requires the experience of a professional with a high knowledge of the attack to execute it correctly. Also, the affectation will be only a small percentage of users and can be recovered quickly. Kappa coefficient. When the results of the expert surveys have been obtained, the concordance between their evaluation is assessed using Cohen's kappa coefficient. The table you can see shows the tabulation of the matching data between the evaluators. Subsequently, the observed and expected probabilities have been calculated as shown below, obtaining the results shown in the next table, which is observed agreement 0.67 and expected agreement 0.33. Finally, the kappa coefficient was calculated resulting in 0.5, meaning that the strength of agreement of the two evaluators is moderate, reinforcing the results obtained through the surveys conducted. However, it should be noted that they may vary to some extent according to the criteria and experience of each evaluator. Stride model-based analysis. The following table shown below is based on the Stride model. This will present an X in the category or categories to which each one of the 18 analyzed attacks belongs. The traits observed in the columns of the table are spoofing, tampering, repudiation, information disclosure, denial of service, and elevation of privilege. Now, in this case, it has been observed that the most important threat to which wearable devices are vulnerable is the disclosure of information. This category violates a very important security property, that is the confidentiality of information. Disclosing it to unauthorized users and allowing them access to unauthorized files or data. Security recommendations. Having analyzed each of the threats, vulnerabilities, risks, and types of attacks that wearable devices are victims of, we proceed to make security recommendations so that these terminals used by millions of users daily and the networks to which they are connected can be more secure. Threat spoofing. Its countermeasures are do not allow sensitive information to be transferred in plain text. Prevent credentials from being stored in plain text. Threat tampering. Countermeasures. Use more restrictive authentication. Use digital signatures. Threat repudiation. Countermeasure. Make hash code comparisons. Use systems that record logs and use digital signatures. Threat information disclosure. Countermeasures. Use secure encryption algorithms. And do not allow sensitive information to be transmitted in plain text. Threat denial of service. Countermeasures. Use bandwidth control or load balancing to disperse the flow of information. Threat elevation of privilege. Countermeasure. Follow the principle of last privilege. Conclusions. First, the emergence of wearable devices has resulted in a large amount of sensitive information traveling through the digital world. Thus, all this data is exposed to the risk of unjustified privacy violations, threatening the lives of users and their security. Consequently, protecting people's privacy has become a major challenge in the development of wearable technology. Second, this work has reviewed and analyzed using the DREAD and STRIDE models the different attacks that wearable devices can suffer and the risk that this entails. Thus, it has been possible to confirm the high importance of information security when working with these devices. Third, wearable technology, despite its rapid growth, is in an early stage of its generation and promises a great future in terms of development. Likewise, their vulnerabilities, threats, and risks to which these devices are exposed are in an initial and research stage that will continue to evolve at the same or higher pace than technology. Thank you for your attention.